Okay, let's be real. Ghostty has been on my radar since basically ever. I've been following Mitchell Hashimoto from my days as a junior DevOps. Mitchell was my hero, CTO and co-founder of one of the most known DevOps companies in the world. Literally made the first commit on projects like Vagrant, Terraform, Nomad, Vault, Packer, and the list goes on. Some of these tools quite literally power large parts of the internet, and they were all open source. So when Mitchell first wrote he was building a new terminal to solve clunky ways other terminals run, I felt like an Apple fanboy before the first iPhone release, sitting outside the store on the curb, waiting to be the first in line. About a year ago, Mitchell even went on a Zig podcast and told all about what he was building, and I was fired up. However, as excited as I was, it turns out you can't really get Ghostty. It's still in private beta, and there's a Mystic Discord server where you need to participate in a conversation, introduce yourself, and then wait, and wait, and then wait some more. And after a few months, I went back and went like, "Yo, what's up with the waiting?" And after a reign of "get in line dude, we're all waiting here," I tried nagging some of the moderators and even pulled the "I'm a YouTuber" card. And yeah, it sounded ridiculous back then too, but it worked. And long story short, I'm sitting now in the back with the cool kids and I joined the Ghostty testers. So this is my humble contribution to the incredible effort that Ghostty project is. Just one comment before you jump on the Ghostty Discord server and telling them how I sent you looking for an invite. The first, Uzaft, did I say that right? Says hi. And the second is, please read the pins. Chris, aka the legendary Typecraft, missed it. So here's my very weak attempt at being better in at least one thing. And don't worry, the public release is coming soon enough, so Ghostty is probably going to be your 2025 terminal. Starting out, Ghostty is open source, of course. It's written in Zig, because why not? Mitchell can do anything, and he literally wanted to experiment. He even announced a recent contribution of $300,000, and yes, you heard that right, that he and his wife made to the Zig Software Foundation. Just because he liked the community while building Ghostty, and like I said, Mitchell can do anything. But wait, why would you even change your setup for a new shiny thing you can't trust? I mean, sure, a couple of cool features, but that's it? Well, they're beyond just cool, and stick around because some are mind-blowing. But here's why, if you ask Mitchell. Ghostty wants to solve the nativeness? Anyway, the flaws all great terminals have when running on different platforms. It's either performance, Windows management, or plain lack of features. Believe me, I used each and every one in the list above. Wisdom, that isn't here, was my go-to up until recently that I got accepted to Ghostty, and believe me when I say I'm never looking back. Before going into the nitty-gritty details, do know that Ghostty is one of, if not the most, actively developed terminal. I see these pop up on a daily basis and Mitchell tweeting about cool new features all the time. I'll start with the little things, like being able to move it around as a native window, which surprisingly enough isn't all that obvious with other terminals. And yes, Mac users, with a small setting you can drag windows by clicking anywhere and dragging with Ctrl and Command pressed. More details in the description. The other immediate, yet still straightforward to some and mind-blowing to others, is the ability to change the text size when zooming in instead of having the screen grow with it. This is especially great when sharing screens or, you know, making YouTube videos around your terminal. Using the same shortcut with Wisdom quickly gets out of hand, or out of screen, rather. Ghostty comes with a CLI, which does many things, but it can't launch the terminal. At least not on my macOS. This means that when trying to fire up something with my favorite app launcher, SKHD, you can't use the CLI, but rather have to turn to the GUI. This isn't a big problem, but it is something to note. If we're honest, after not having the option with Wisdom at all and hacking my way around it with weird keyboard combos, having SKHD pop Ghostty when I need it is a game changer. Now let's talk about Ghosty's config, because that's what we're here for. To start off, if you're a Nix Home Manager user like me, and more about that in the video above, add the config path to your home flake. Ghostty uses the conventional XDG home path, and a simple .config/ghostty is all you need. Now, popping the config is as easy as opening the config file under the Ghostty config path. But if you just need a quick glance or a quick change, similar to other applications like Obsidian, Ghostty pops the trunk if you hit Command and comma. You get your configuration as text file within a text editor, which is super neat and thoughtful addition. Naturally, I can't change it through the direct file because Home Manager protects me from that, but if you manage your .files directly, knock yourself out. On to the configuration itself. A simple key value does the job. You can comment lines as you see me do here, and the docs are basically the Zig configurations code, but man, Mitchell and the team are doing an amazing job leaving super helpful documentation everywhere. I'll show you how to get that with the CLI a bit later. Not everything is perfect with Ghostty. Yazzie still has issues showing images, for example, and while some users report it differently, as you can see here, I'm still having issues. This is something WesTerm, for example, handles flawlessly and never had issues with. If we're totally honest, images in the terminal never felt like a win to me, but still, Ghostty isn't free of the odd flaw here and there. Anyway, this is a great place to mention I have a new Kubernetes from scratch course out. If you've heard about Kubernetes but never actually got the chance to dive in, or didn't have the time and energy to start devouring books and hundreds of pages, I've got you covered. With different short modules and tests, building up familiarity with Kubernetes through hands-on work. I'll take you from zero to running your own application on a cluster. All right, moving on. Let's go back to the config and look at cool stuff Ghostty can do. I picked a pair of configuration options I've been asked countless times on, and while my terminal is blurred and semi-transparent in the background right here in the video, this isn't actually a configuration, but a video editing trick that does this. With Ghostty, you can do it using configuration. Setting opacity is quite common, but Ghostty lets you combine that with a much-needed blurry effect that gives you the same feel. Again, I think this is a Mac-only feature, but check me on that. Let's test it, and for the sake of even testing round, I'll lose my video effects for a few seconds, but bear with me. To apply the changes, I'm running Home Manager switch, and another cool feature of Ghostty in the configuration is its config reload shortcut. Just add a shift to the command comma combo from earlier, and the terminal reloads the changes. No more wondering whether something made it through or didn't, and by the way, if you do make a mistake or set a non-existing option, Ghostty will let you know, so that you don't chase your own tail trying to figure out what went wrong. So here's the opacity and blur effects in action. Let's pop the Mac Finder to see the change in a more obvious way. And this is what it looks like in reality. Not too bad. I'm not a fan of terminal opacity or background images, as to me this is mostly distracting, but with this kind of setting, it may just be beneficial to see what's underneath. So here's the Ghostty project, which you'll eventually see in full when it turns open source. There are a bunch of explanations and tester instructions, there are configuration options and theme coverage, and we'll talk about this one in a bit because it's too cool to ignore. The config structure I mentioned earlier is just a long Zig file with a configuration class and settings, but it's also a huge list of options, and the best part about it is the level of detailed explanations and examples right there in the code. As with basically everything else on the internet, there's a Catpuccin theme for Ghostty as well, and I naturally had it set up from the start without messing about. It's a simple config line that you've probably seen on my configuration file, so this is a good point to remind you of my .dot files, they're open and updated on GitHub. Give me a star because we're almost at 1k. Remember the cool theme feature I talked about? As with every other cool feature, Mitchell tweets about it and I immediately run to see what's up. So with Ghostty List themes, you can see this super impressive dashboard where you can scroll around themes. There are hundreds, if not thousands here, and different flavors and styles. You can scroll through, browse, or even use the vim/search command to pop a search bar and use a fuzzy searcher that will help you find what you're looking for. Remember our friendly CLI? The one that comes with the GUI? Well, the docs are packed into it. And running Ghostty plus show config --- default and then --- docs pops the entire documentation to your terminal for you to browse the options. With show key bindings, it'll find all the options, including those you've configured, and compiles them into a colorful list that's super convenient to see when you need it. And now, finally, let me show you my favorite Ghostty feature. Something that may have killed one of my TMUX plugins altogether. I don't know if you're aware of Flokes, one of my plugins that I built with some amazing group of contributors. The point of Flokes is to pop a terminal as an overlay in the current working environment. With this in mind, I was actually browsing Twitter, well, not actually browsing, I was doom scrolling, when I suddenly saw this. Mitchell introduced a new feature, the Quick Terminal. The second I figured out what I was seeing, I was blown away. I went ahead, updated to the latest release, and added a keybind, and check this out. I can now pop a terminal, scrolling down from the top of my screen. I can attach it to TMUX, split it, and do basically whatever I want. And then I can scroll it back up when I'm done. Who needs a floating terminal when I have that? Bear in mind, this is a Mac feature only, and as far as I know, many users would actually rather have a floating terminal within the context of their own terminal screen, not scrolling freely like a stage curtain on the screen, but still, you gotta admit the slickness of this thing. One of the most useful things I do with it, which is just one example of many, is running my flake build command or the home manager switch sync. In terms of roadmap and where Ghosty stands, it already offers competitive performance. Mitchell actually admits it doesn't necessarily lead the pack, but it wasn't designed to. It is definitely giving a fight and probably fast enough for 99% of users to never notice a difference. It's super customizable, it's user-friendly, it offers cool and helpful features that I like to categorize as friction removers. There's still work to be done with native integrations. It's not fully integratable into Windows and other fancy options, but they're all coming. Lastly, before wrapping up, like many alternatives, Ghosty comes with its own multiplexing capabilities. You can create tabs and scroll through them, but this is something even iTerm can do. No hard feelings, iTerm users, but you're using ancient technology. Ghosty can split both vertically and horizontally, and here are two things I noticed right away. The first, it's super easy and straightforward to move around. So easy I literally figured it out by playing around. Can't say I ever figured out lateral pane movement just by hitting common combinations, surely not with Tmux. Command Option and Arrow, or Super Alt and Arrows for you users of other platforms, takes you to the pane in the direction pointed at. The other thing, and much more interesting thing I've noticed about it, is the crazy speed in which a new split and the shell with it starts. Check this out. New splits with Ghosty and then doing the same with Tmux. It's noticeably slower and lagging behind. Not sure whether this is the native Windows split or the complexity Tmux adds on top of the terminal or both, but this thing just works and it works fast. That's it. Ghosty, even while in closed beta, has a thriving tester community. Different features and discussions happen daily, and cool ideas like Zen mode and others pop all the time. I can't wait for the open source release when these things will take off on another scale. Ghosty is really one of a kind. But a good terminal emulator is just a start. If you want to take things to the next level, utilizing your terminal with a nicer prompt, better config, and a workflow that feels smooth and blazing fast, check out my complete setup in the video next. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.